It's time to wake up and win the weekend.
You're listening to the boss of the big ball, JP the Kicker, giving you that grease.
Join me every Saturday and Sunday from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. Pacific Time for the live action on Vegas Scoreboard Express on KSHP 107.1 FM and AM 1400. Dive into the game day with my in-depth analysis, expert predictions, and winning plays from the sharpest minds in sports betting. It's more than just placing bets. It's about securing wins. Head over to jbtheticket.com and be sure to tune in to KSHP this weekend from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. Pacific Time to ride the winning wave with VSX. Tune in and get your money back from the sports book. All money, all sports, no bull.
Missed the live show? Subscribe to Vegas Scoreboard Express on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, TuneIn, and wherever you enjoy your favorite podcast and radio listening.
You're tuned into the VSX Digital Sports Network.
You are rocking with the hottest. Put your hands up for the boss. The mix master is live. Get ready.
Young flow spitting at me. Young rappers getting at me. Money getting big, predicted this exactly. More money, more problems.
You're listening to the boss of the big ball.
When you getting money like athletes. Young, it's ice grilling me. Oh, you not feeling me fine. It costs you nothing. Pay me no mind.
JP the Kicker.
Ain't got time for running. Sensitive thugs, y'all all need hugs. Damn, little mans, I'm just trying to do me. If the record's 2 mil, I'm just trying to move 3.
Get a Vegas scoreboard express.
Hopefully they're menage before I reach my garage. I don't want much, oh, I drove every car. Some nice cooked food, some nice clean drawers. Bird tagging us, I don't mean to ruffle y'all. I know you waiting in the wing, but I'm
giving you that grease.
That's right, I'm waking you up this morning. JP the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express. Ain't no love in the city. JPTheTicket.com. You know what time it is, 107.1 FM and AM 1400. Brought my mans with me, Troy West, 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 West. Seattle's finest, the top handicapper in the nation. Came to the city, showed love, showed respect. Broke bread with your boy, JP. Good morning, Troy. How you doing this morning, my man?
JB, it's great to be on with the best in Las Vegas, my friend. It's great to be with you, my friend.
Glad to have you. We're going to talk some college basketball today. Give you a little bit of preview for the big game. Again, you can go to my website, jbtheticket.com. I got everything that you need to get you where you want to be. Giving you a little bit of Jay-Z this morning. You know what time it is. I'm not tripping. Because I'm the only one giving grease each and every weekend. Nobody is better. When we come back from the short commercial break, we're jumping into a college basketball. Troy West, let's get ready to crack it. Let's get the money.
You're listening to the boss of the big ball.
Take him to church.
JP the Kicker.
In the heart of town.
The Richard Pryor going burn up. And Ike and Tina turn up, break up. Then I wake up to more bullshit.
You're tuned into the VSX Digital Sports Network.
Successful, you pull it, ish. Again, I step on your porch, step to your boss. Let's end the speculation, I'm talking to all of y'all. Male shouldn't be jealous, that's a female trait. What you mad, cause you push down, but he sell weight. Y'all don't know my expenses, I gotta buy bigger plates. And more baggies, why you all aggy? Written respect the game, that should be it. What you eat don't make me ish.
JP the Kicker, giving you that grease.
Skip your cable bill this month and join the action with JB and Fubo TV. Get 7 days free, 15% off your first month. No credit check, no deposit, no installation hassle. Go to FuboTV.com/JB. Sign up, download the app, and start watching games.
Enjoy being a subscriber after the first month. Easy cancellation anytime. Regional restrictions apply. Sign up at VegasScoreboardExpress.com.
You're tuned into the BSX Digital Sports Network.
But I want to ask you one question. If I had some nuts hanging on the walls, what would I have, honey? I just, darling, you have some walnuts.
You are rocking with the hottest. Put your hands up for the boss. The mix master is live. Get ready.
You're listening to the boss of the big boy. JB the Tech Guy, giving you that grease.
Troy West, we're back. JB the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express. A little bit of Dr. Dre. D's, you know what time it is. In your mouth, waking you up early, giving you the grease. Follow me on Instagram at JB the Ticket if you want to. Go to my website, jbtheticket.com, if you're trying to get paid. Or you can keep playing around outside with the suckers. Troy, let's jump into it. It's time to wake up and give these folks what they're used to each and every weekend. JB the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express, boss of the big board, man. I want to talk to you this week, Troy. How have you been this big game week, man? How have you been out there in Seattle making it happen? I know you got a lot of prop bets. We got some college basketball bets we're going to be talking about today, but I just wanted to catch up with you, my man, because you're the homeboy, man, and we appreciate everything that you've helped me do over the last year and a half. Never asked for nothing, never needed nothing. Just came to the front gate and was like, look, JB, I want to help you drop some fish grease. Go ahead, brother.
Absolutely, JB. Yeah, six straight winning days. And we're hoping to give Las Vegas a treat this morning. It's always an honor to be on with the legend yourself. And like I said, you're one of the best in the business, so I appreciate being on with you each and every Saturday and Sunday morning.
I thank you so much for that. You know, there was a lot of folks asking me, you know, if I was over at the big game and doing different things like that. And like I told them, I said, you know what? I'm here. I'm doing what I do. I'm known nationwide, worldwide, around the world. They know where to find me if they so do choose. And I'm still going to be rocking number one in the nation. So let's jump into it again. Vegas Scoreboard Express, college basketball Saturday, being brought to you by our friends over at Fubo TV. That's right. Go to FuboTV.com/JB. That's going to give you 15% off, 7 days free. Also got the Paramount Plus for you if you want to watch the big game tomorrow. Absolutely free. I'm hooking you guys up with that. Go to jbtheticket.com, vegasscoreboardexpress.com, vsxdigitalsportsnetwork.com. Click any of those live banner links and you can watch the big game free and the college basketball that we got on the line today. So I want to jump into it with you real quick here. Talking about this Big Ten, it seems to be the best conference in college basketball. As I look through the records, as I look through the rankings, the Big Ten seems to have quite a few teams. And there's one team that we wanted to talk about today. To get it kind of started early, a 9 o'clock game, give somebody something to bet on. I wanted to talk about number 11, the Wisconsin Badgers. They're on the road going out to Piscataway this morning to play Rutgers. Rotation number 601, the Wisconsin Badgers at the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. And you talk about this team, rotation number 602, Rutgers at 12-10. They seem to be a pedestrian team this year. 9-3 at home. You guys know there's a lot of parity in college basketball. As I said before, the talent level isn't there. The offensive creativity isn't there. And the turnovers definitely are residing. But you come in with the Wisconsin team at 15-7, -3.5. Troy West, I'm going to throw this one at you here, buddy. What seems to be wrong with Wisconsin? Why can't they come in with, say, maybe a -5, a -6 in this game? Is it because of the road? Is it because of weather? Why are the bookmakers trying to say that Rutgers is a dog that's barking at home? Go ahead.
Yeah, JB, this is one of those, the dog is barking at home, baby. I know you love those home underdogs. You know, Wisconsin played their Super Bowl last week against Purdue at home. It was a dog fight all game long. They ultimately fell short to Purdue. And again, that was one of those 110% exhausting basketball games. Now you got to go on the road, go up into New York, face a Rutgers team that's not very good. But, you know, it's just got letdowns screaming all over it. It's got low scoring written all over it. I think Rutgers sticks out a tight one, 60-58.
He likes the money line here. When you talk about the money line, looking at Rutgers plus 151, I've looked at a lot of the money lines today in college basketball, a couple of big names having their chance to make history. Let's talk about it. This is a big one. Rotation number 605, the Connecticut Huskies, number one team in the nation. Again, no one's talking about these guys. I couldn't tell you who is their starting five. And I've looked, believe me, I have been looking all over the internet. I've even gone to their student athletic website. The information seems to be somewhat generic, but these guys are minus 16 today, playing a Georgetown team that is so far down in the cellar. They fired Pat Ewing a couple of seasons ago, and now these guys are absolutely atrocious in college basketball. Talking about rotation number 605, the number one Connecticut Huskies. These guys are national champions. 21-2, minus 16.5. The line has gone up. Georgetown, another home dog today. Biggest home dog that I could find. And I don't really know where to play this one here because Georgetown, 8-4, 7-7 at home. They're 10-12 against the spread, but only 4-10 against the spread at home. Total in this game is a 142. Now, last weekend, we saw Connecticut run the tables. They're playing a very strong schedule, but again, they're doing it quietly. Okay. They're pretty much beating each and every team that is in front of them. They beat St. John's that day. We thought the St. John's would be able to be a dog barking. They came back the very next week and beat up on Butler. So UConn is just rolling along. And when you look at the Georgetown Hoyas, you know, long gone are the glory days. They've got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Yeah, almost like nine losses. I mean, I don't think this one is a dog that is barking. I'm looking at it from the perspective, though, of a win for the Huskies. Do you like the total here? We're trying to find some value with these top 25 teams. Troy, go ahead.
Yeah, you know, UConn's been outstanding, led by Cam Spencer, their shooting guard. The guy's been outstanding all year. You got to remember, too, these are the defending champs, right? So they're getting everybody's best shot. I mean, even just a couple days ago, JB, they were favored by 15.5 points against Butler. They only won that game by 11. This is a really good UConn team, but they're not covering machines. I like Georgetown at home. Do I think they're going to win the game? Absolutely not. But I think even a 70-57 type of basketball game gets you the cover. Give me the Hoyas at home getting too many points.
Right. Hoyas right now 16.5. You got Connecticut going right down the road. If you talk about tune-ups, I look at Connecticut's schedule, and I don't see any holes. I know that we're coming up into the next game here. When we get back from this short commercial break, going to be talking about your favorite Purdue Boilermakers. Again, shout out to Purdue Online. Appreciate everything you're doing for your man, JB. Tell the fans where they can get your picks, Troy, and we take this short commercial break, come back, and jump into this college basketball slate. Tons of games, as there are each and every weekend, and we're going to be picking the best ones for you. And then before we get out of here, going to touch a little bit on the big game, maybe give out a couple of prop bets. Got the special show coming tomorrow. Again, Troy West will be back with you, a couple other guys from the big board. So go ahead, Troy, tell them where they can get those picks.
Yeah, get to TroyWins.com. We've had six straight winning days. If you go to that website and type in your phone number, you're going to get today's slate. Absolutely free. You can also go to TWProfits.com. That's our entire prop division, and we also cover Pride Fix there. So everything's free today, guys. Put in your phone number, and one myself and one of my colleagues will get you the entire slate absolutely free.
And I'm telling you, I met Troy West live, man. He's a real dude. He really makes these bets. I've seen him cash tickets. You know what I mean? Like I said before, real deal sports betting grease. So when we get back from the short commercial break, we're going to come back and give you more college basketball. Grab your bankroll. Get ready. And let's get the money. JB the ticket. VSX Digital Sports Networks. Let's get the money.
You're listening to the boss of the big boy, JB the ticket. Giving you that grease.
Skip your cable bill this month and join the action with JB and Fubo TV. Get 7 days free, 15% off your first month. No credit check, no deposit, no installation hassle. Go to FuboTV.com/JB. Sign up, download the app, and start watching games.
Enjoy being a subscriber after the first month. Easy cancellation anytime. Regional restrictions apply. Sign up at VegasScoreboardExpress.com.
In times of war and peace, the men and women of our military dedicate themselves to serving our country. We salute those who have given their lives for our country. Their sacrifice, will never be forgotten.
This salute is courtesy of Mac and Grill Cheese Factory, serving our area with quality and pride. For a fantastic meal, stop by 1331 West Warm Springs Road in Henderson or call them at 725-214-4140. That's 725-214-4140. Mac and Grill Cheese Factory, on the air, reminding everyone that we live in the land of the free thanks to our Brave.
You're tuned into the BSX Digital Sports Network.
You are rocking with the hottest. Put your hands up for the boss. The Mixmaster is live. Get ready.
I got a honey cup.
You're listening to the boss of the big boss.
I'm from New York, New York. I got a semi-automatic that spits next time if you talk.
JP the Kekka.
Honey guns are honey clips. I'm from New York, New York. I got a semi-automatic that spits
giving
next time
you
if
that
you talk. And I know.
Back at you live, JP the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express. You know I'm from New York City. That's right, Queens. Born Harlem bred, giving you the grease, waking you up each and every Saturday. Right here on KSHP, AM 1400 and 107.1 FM. Got my special guest on the line with me this morning, all hour long, giving you the grease. Troy West, 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 West from TroyWins.com, TWProps.com. Again, I've sat down with Troy. I've seen him make his bets. He came all the way out from Seattle. First person he called when he touched down in the city. It's called tapping in. You know, he knows what time it is, and he always makes sure that he brings the grease, Troy. So glad to have you back here on the line with me. We're talking some college basketball today. It has been an eventful year. You like the Purdue Boilermakers. Let's talk a little bit about this team. Give the fans out there some of the information that you have, because when you look at this team, they were supposed to really compete for the national championship last year, but they're right on the heels of UConn at 21-2. They're playing Indiana today, and you look at where they're at in the schedule coming into March. Do you think Purdue, not only after you give fans a little bit of a preview of what they're about, but do you think that they're going to get stronger as we go into March? And do you think that they can possibly pick up a number one seed? Go ahead.
Yeah, I think right now they're battling UConn to be that number one overall seed. This is such a good Purdue basketball team led by their center, Zach Edey. This guy is an absolute force down low, JP. They can shoot the ball outside. Let's not forget, they're really well coached. Matt Painter has been with Purdue a very long time. This team is seasoned to make a deep run. I love Purdue still at plus 800, JB. This team's solid. They've played a Big Ten schedule. They played a huge non-conference schedule as well. I love Purdue to get the job done this year, JB.
I'm telling you, he's been telling me Purdue. You said last week that you're coming to Vegas next week. You were like, JB, you got to get me those odds. We're going to go in on a ticket together. That's right. I'm going to make sure that I have my money on it with you, man, because I'm looking at this today, rotation number 800. Talk about some magic there, plus 800. Talk about the Celestial Network working with you. Their rotation number 800 today, the Purdue Boilermakers, got a huge spread in front of them, 17.5 is the line today. 21-2, 11-0 at home. Purdue is at home today, but they're taking on the Indiana Hoosiers, who, in my opinion, they haven't been as good as they should be. I watched them play a game last week that should have been a lot stronger for them, a lot of teeter-tottering. But at 14-9, we have seen this time and time again with the plethora of postseason college basketball tournaments. Indiana, most likely, in my opinion, an NIT team. If they can make a strong run in the Big Ten tournament, they may come in on the bubble. But at 14-9 today, going up against this juggernaut of Purdue, do you think Indiana comes in and not only picks up their 10th loss, but they do it not covering that 17.5 spread? I've seen some things that Purdue can do, and when I look at it from the perspective of spreads, 17.5 isn't that bad when you've got a team that can really shoot the lights out from the outside the way Purdue has been doing. I've watched a couple of their games, a couple of their highlights. You know, it's hard for me to sit through a lot of the college basketball outside of that because of, you know, the way they play now. But when you talk about winning games and putting cash in your pocket, Purdue, do you think they got that 17.5 locked up today? Or do you want to buy it down a little bit here? Maybe, you know, give Purdue some breathing room, maybe a -9, something like that. Go ahead, Troy.
Yeah, it's a lot of points. And you got to remember, like I said, JB, when you get a team like Purdue, who's been number one in the country, number two all year long, they get everybody's best shot. So Indiana's going to go in there with house money, no pressure. It's a lot of points, man. I think Purdue wins the game, but, man, Indiana, I think, probably hangs within the number. I'd like the score to be like an 84-70 type of basketball game. That's a lot of points, though, JB. You got to take the Hoosiers plus the points.
You got to take the Hoosiers plus the points. What I'm going to end up doing today, I'm buying Purdue down a half here. 8.5 should be able to get you paid. And a lot of people are like, well, JB, you're not going with the dog here. Yeah, but I'm going with the win. Going with the win. That's right. Going with the win. Waking you up early in the morning here. I was waiting for some oil to get on the board. Moving back along down in the college basketball ranks. Let's move into the ACC now. Talking about this game here. Pretty interesting. Rotation number 609. The Clemson Tigers -3.5, -165. Going up against the Syracuse Orangemen. This is another 9 o'clock game. About a half hour before you get to the window. +3.5 at home. Talking about a home dog barking. Syracuse, is there any chance for these guys to get back into basketball prominence as well? Because ever since that Boeheim kind of picked up and, you know, left and did everything that he did over the last couple of years, they haven't really been as strong as you would look for them. When you see the Clemson team coming in today, 15-7, 12-10 against the spread, going up against an 11-1 team at home, and Syracuse 14-8 overall. But Syracuse does have some problems covering spreads at 8-14. But most of the losses that I saw them on the spread line were when they were favored. Do you like Syracuse as a home dog today? Go ahead, Troy.
I don't. You know, this Clemson team's playing really good basketball right now, JB. They went on the road. They should have won at Duke last week, lost by one. And then they went into North Carolina earlier this week and actually took care of business quite handily. Clemson's playing really good basketball right now. They've moved the ball well. I like Clemson to go into Syracuse. Syracuse just does not play good defense anymore. It'll be a high-scoring game. Clemson pulls out the victory.
He's telling you, Clemson comes in. The Tigers are going to be ripping off the orange peels. Moving into another game that was interesting to me today. Full college basketball slate today, guys. That's right. Going back to the old way, Vegas Scoreboard Express. Pick what you like. Do what you like. Again, in memory of my main man, Pop DiBiase. Also want to give a shout-out in heaven to Carl Weathers, a.k.a. Apollo Creed. Now, anyone who's ever boxed with me or gone to kickboxing, they know I got the Apollo Creed gloves that I've trained in, the American flag gloves. That's right. Shout out my armed forces also tuned in this morning. Let's go back to college basketball, though. Talking about the SEC now, rotation number 6-1-1, the Alabama Crimson Tide -7. Going up against LSU, and Alabama is on the road. Rotation number 6-1-2. LSU +7, +263 on the money line. This is one of the value home dogs that I like in this particular matchup today, Troy. When I look at where Alabama has been over the last couple of seasons, had a first round draft pick last year, but haven't done too much since that. And in relationship to them being ranked number 16, I think that's just because they need some filler in that top 25. I told you that a lot of teams in there are foreign to me, but we are seeing some stalwarts, if you will. But you talk about this team here coming in with the LSU Tigers, 11-10, hovering around 500, but they got a strong record at 9-3 at home. Alabama only 3-3 at home, 3-3 on the road against the spread, 13-9 against the spread. LSU 7.5 today. Do they get a pride win coming into today's matchup versus Alabama? You know, the number 16 team most likely is going to get the best shot from the Tigers based on the fact the Tigers aren't ranked. Go ahead.
Yeah, I like LSU as well, JB. I'm going to buy a point on this thing, get it up to 8.5. Give me the Tigers at home. You know, Alabama just a couple days ago gets blown out on the road at Auburn. Now you got to go on the road again at LSU. That's no easy freight as well. I think it's going to be a good basketball game. But I'll take the points at home all day long in this one, baby.
I like the points, too. LSU, again, that's my dog of the day, college basketball. Being brought to you by our friends over at Fubo TV. Go to FuboTV.com/JP. You get 15% off Watch the Game. And then also, we've got the Paramount Plus for you as well, giving you a full 30 days absolutely free. Not going to cost you any money in that relationship. Moving into another game today that a lot of people have been talking about from a college basketball perspective. And I have been looking at it on the line today. Want to talk about it. Creighton and Xavier, they took all the value away. Game opened up at 3.5. Totals 154.5. Rotation number 617. the Creighton Blue Jays -1 on the road. But if you like the Musketeers of Xavier, rotation number 618, they're only giving you +1, even money on the money line. And Troy, I want to talk to you a little bit about this going into the sports betting side of it. The books seem to have taken a lot of the value out of the college basketball regular season. And I'm not saying that to be facetious. I'm just looking at it from, if you see a top team in the rankings, okay, Creighton's coming in at number 19. You don't see a lot of value coming in from the betting public, and also from the sports line makers. They're not making the favorites or the ranked teams get as much value as you would think. So when you look at this game here today, Troy, do you think that the reality is Creighton -1, they got to win by one, lose by none, or do you want to go with Xavier here and say, well, take the +1, but if you're taking +1 to give the better some education and there's even money on the money line, there really is no value with that unless you just want to bet the dog at home from an alumni betting perspective. Go ahead, Troy.
Yeah, I'm going with Creighton, JB. Here's why. This is actually one of my bigger plays on today's slate. Creighton lost a heartbreaker to Butler last week, 99-98. Yes, you heard that, 99-98. Then they lost in overtime last game to Providence, 85-78. This Creighton team is going to be hungry today, JB. I don't see them losing three straight ball games. They got too much talent. They're well coached. Xavier's good. Creighton beat them earlier in the year by 7. They're going to go on the road today and take care of them again. They're not losing three straight. Give me Creighton.
They got to get to work. Creighton -1. I like it as well. Basically, it's two dogs going at it. You're talking about Creighton not wanting to fall out of the rankings. Three straight losses would do that. Troy, thank you so much for rocking with me this morning. Again, thank you guys out in Vegas and around the world listening on KSHP, AM 1400, 107.1 FM, on my website at jbtheticket.com. Again, you guys can go to my website and pick up the daily deals. Got some packages for you there. Got the free pick. You can also register for that. We don't spam your email. Not going to ask you for anything. Just going to send you out that free pick. Just want you to lend me your ear for 1 hour each and every Saturday and Sunday, 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. So, Troy, we're at the half hour. Going to take a quick commercial break. Catch your breath. Sounds like you're running on the treadmill. Want to give a shout-out to my two guys, the two Rons. Ron, third down best bets. Ronnie B., Las Vegas. Linwood Hard Rock Hamilton, defender of the youth. Again, he's out there working to get that documentary. Got some rough news about the case, but the dogs are still barking for you. Troy, another quick shout-out, and then we'll go ahead and take this short commercial break. Go ahead.
Yeah, JB, again, thank you so much for having me on each and every weekend. You're the best in the business. Looking forward to being in Vegas with you next weekend. Get to TroyWins.com. Get to our Instagram. It's Troy West. Today's slate is massive, and it's absolutely free.
The slate is massive, absolutely free. Here to put cash in your pocket. Troy, thank you so much for your accolades, support, and most importantly, respect. When I come back from this short commercial break, people, we're going to get back into it. Another half hour of college basketball picks live on KSHP 107.1 FM, VSX Digital Sports Networks. JB the Ticket. You know what time it is. You better get some money.
You're listening to the boss of the big boy, JB the Ticket. Giving you that grease.
Basketball season is heating up, so stay in the game with Fubo TV. Get the NBA, NCAA, FIBA, and more. Get 7 days free at VegasScoreboardExpress.com. Don't get cabled. Get Fubo TV.
Back up this Saturday morning here with my main man Troy West. From TroyWins.com, JP the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express, VSX Digital Sports Network. You can go to my website, JPTheTicket.com. That's where you get all my plays, all my picks. You can learn about me and get some great deals. So we're talking about this college basketball again this Saturday, being brought to you by our friends over at Fubo TV. Go to FuboTV.com/JB and you save 15% if you want to. If you don't want to keep paying your cable bill and have your credit go to collections, don't do it. I'm not tripping. I'm just going to keep doing what I'm doing. Again, Troy West, so glad to have you back on the line. Let's jump back into some of this college basketball again. I've been looking at it. The tournament is coming up. We're going to have a lot of opportunity over the next couple of weeks to give fans a lot of plays to can put cash in their pocket. Let's talk a little bit about the top 25, though, because if you go all the way from top to bottom, you even got New Mexico kicking around the bottom, San Diego State at number 24, Texas Tech, Kentucky at number 17. When you look at the change of college basketball, though, over the last 10 years, okay, the stalwarts of the ACC, you got North Carolina there at number 3, Big 12 teams, Kansas, Duke at 9, and then 10, Illinois. Do you think college basketball, in my opinion, it's always going to be this way from now on, but do you think that the parity is still going to be there? You talk about Purdue having a chance to win the national championship this year. Do you think it's just because the talent is kind of even across the board? I think that's one of the main reasons that we're seeing these records of 17 and 10, 15 and 9. You know, I'm looking, scrolling right now. I can literally, in a four block here with all the games here, a total of, let's see, look at this team, 11 wins, 15 wins, 16 wins, 14 wins, 14 wins, 15 wins. That, to me, is parity of talent. Go ahead, Troy.
Yeah, I mean, it's been awesome, JB. And you know, last year you look at it, San Diego State played for a national championship last year and really could have won the whole thing. I mean, Alabama last year was the clear number one. They get knocked out before the Sweet 16. Parity's there in college basketball. I think this year, like I said, you're top heavy with your UConns, your Purdues, your Houstons. You're top heavy, but man, I'll tell you what, it's another year where really there's probably about 25 teams that can win the whole thing.
Right. And when you talk about the smaller schools, last year you saw Florida Atlantic, FAU again, FAU Owls. You know what my big gripe is, though? You don't know who these kids are. Couldn't name their starting five last year. I don't really see them in the rankings this year going back to the top 25. You look at a team like, well, there they are, FAU. They are in the top 25, number 20 at 18-5. They play Wichita State today. So you talk about a Cinderella last year who's maintained. They're in the top 25. Where does that leave some of the bigger names that we're used to seeing? You know one name I don't see? I don't see UCLA on here. What happened? We know the Pac-12 is no longer around. But to not see UCLA in the top 25, to not see Florida in the top 25, teams that we have been used to over the last couple of seasons having that ability to get deep into the tournament, to be relevant, do you think that we're moving into the era where maybe a Creighton, a Dayton, these two teams, Creighton at number 19, Dayton at number 18, FAU at 20, some of these smaller schools, you mentioned San Diego State last year, getting to the national championship game with that clutch jump shot. Do you feel that this is finally going to be the era where a true mid-major, a true small school, wins the national championship? We've seen them knocking at the door, going all the way back to, I think it was 2006, 2008, something like that. George Mason started it in the Colonials Athletic Conference. They went all the way to the Final Four. And then over the last 20 years, going on 20 years, I've seen a lot of these smaller schools slowly but surely creep up in the rankings. And with the NIL era being the way that it is, players being able to go to the transfer portal and not have to stay somewhere 4 years, and also the recruitment to the elevation of the next level, the NBA or one of these FIBA organizations overseas, you're seeing a lot more talent in college basketball that's just never going to sniff the pros. And okay, that's just the reality. But the good news is, from my talking with sports bettors like my main man Troy West here, is that you guys kind of like the parity, because some of the bigger odds, the plus 500s, the longer odds to go to Sweet 16s, to go to Final Fours, Elite Eights, even national championship appearances, seems to be a lot more on the table. Troy, back to you.
Yeah, and you don't even have Gonzaga in this conversation anymore either, JB. I mean, Pierce is making the tournament, and I still think they'll make the tournament, JB. But, you know, like you said, Gonzaga, UCLA, you got a lot of conferences down this year. The Pac-12, I mean, my God, they might only send one team to the tournament this year in Arizona. They've got Oregon who's floating around. You've got, you know, Oregon's floating around, Colorado's floating around, Utah, but, you know, they're down as well. I just think the recruiting out there isn't as good as we've seen in the past. I mean, you look at USC, Bronny James. I mean, this guy was supposed to be a prodigy, an NBA product. You know, he has had a brutal season. USC's had a brutal season. This is another team that we've seen in the tournament. So, yeah, this is a great year for a team like Florida Atlantic, who made a deep run last year. They bring back a lot of guys this year. They've been consistent all year. You might see a team like them in the Final Four, and you might see another mid-major sneak in, because like you said, maybe a lot of these teams we're used to seeing, they've had down recruiting classes, and it's really starting to show.
Yeah, I was just looking at some highlights here. Get our friends at CBS HQ, Paramount Plus, CBS, thank you guys so much for getting that fixed for me. I'm just looking at some of the play from some of the players. Last night, San Diego State went up against Nevada up in Reno, and it went to overtime. And I'm looking at some of the late game plays, and Nevada, you know, wins this game. They run on the court like it's a championship. But look, guys, it's a regular season game, and you're playing against guys that can't shoot, okay? I just watched 4 or 5 missed layups, and I'm literally just sitting there saying to myself, like, wait a minute, this is the San Diego State last year where the guy hit a pull-up jumper and they're missing point-blank layups. So if you lose to Nevada last night and have them jump around on the court like they made it to the Sweet 16, how do you feel that a team such as San Diego State, who, again, is right cracking in the top 25 at number 24, they go up against the Colorado State team, which seems to be a little bit better in basketball coming up this Tuesday. But, again, the relationship between star basketball players and college basketball, do you think it's forever severed? You mentioned Bronny James, okay? And I don't want to get too much into, you know, children of, you know, pro players, because that's really, we talked about that already. That's what you're seeing. You know, that doesn't surprise me that not only is he not having the season that he wanted to have, let's not forget the young man, you know, came back from that heart condition. And we saw that happen with Shaq's kid. So I don't know what that may be about in relationship to his health or his readiness to go. But, you know, the coaching at USC is atrocious. Oh, my God. You know, and he's sitting on the bench. And I'm just saying, you know, the college coach is the star of the college basketball arena. And when you look at the way all these kids play, it's all the same. It's all cookie cutter. So my question again is, from a college basketball perspective, if you're looking at a team that has a star, like that one guy that nobody knows about that can really, you know, take over a game and just be that guy, like we used to see back in the days of Antoine Jameson and you know, Vince Carter, the UNC boys, Jay Williams, Duke. You know, every team had that dude, if you will. And I just don't see that in college basketball. So do you think that that's going to continue to be a trend? First question, again, like we mentioned before, the separation of the star from college basketball. And are we going to continue to see college basketball coaching dominate the headlines, which means less information about the players going forward? Go ahead.
Yeah, I agree with you, JB. It really is coming down to coaching right now. Right, it is. I mean, you just don't have those star players. Next year, you might get it. Duke's got some stars coming in, but, you know, even Calipari, you know, at Kentucky. I mean, Kentucky hasn't been the big name that we've seen over the last few years. They don't have that star player that everybody's waiting to go to the lottery. Same with Kansas. I mean, Kansas is a good basketball team this year, but they don't have the star power that everybody thinks that they normally have. You're right. It's going to be interesting if the landscape's changed or if this year's just an anomaly.
Well, I think the landscape has changed, because when you look at the relationship between the player, the recruitment, the high school, the story, okay, the story of the basketball star. Remember, I told you there's been that disconnect between public school ball, prep school ball, and the college court. And when you look at the skill level of these college players, it's really, in my opinion, high level well, not so much high level, but like a basic fundamentals type game. And I also noticed that there's just a lot of below the rim play. I mean, they were talking about lowering the rims for the girls. Might want to lower the rims for the boys when I come back from this short commercial break. Going to be talking to it. Troy West, again, TroyWins.com. Thank you so much, me man. You know, I've been dealing with it, getting it done this week, you know, getting the show ready. I'm going to be taking a vacation. But, Troy, again, tell them where to go to your website and get those picks. Go ahead.
Yeah, baby, I appreciate it. TroyWins.com. We're giving today's slate absolutely free. Put in your phone number and myself or a colleague. Be sure to get you the play free. And we've got about 7 or 8 plays that we love this weekend, baby.
I'm telling you guys, you're going to want to stay tuned here. Troy West has got you covered. College basketball, they got the prop bets, most everything you need to put cash in your pocket. When I get back from this short commercial break, we're going to finish it up with our best bets for the college basketball day so you can get out there and get some money. It's cold, but we're going to keep it hot. Get the money.
You're listening to the boss of the big ball. JP the Kicker.
Basketball season is heating up, so stay in the game with Fubo TV. Get the NBA, NCAA, FIBA, and more. Get 7 days free at VegasScoreboardExpress.com. Don't get cabled. Get Fubo TV.
You're tuned into the BSX Digital Sports Network.
It's just a public service announcement.
You are rocking with the hottest. Put your hands up for the boss.
Fellow Americans.
The Mixmaster is live. Get ready.
Testament and recollection of history in the making during our generation.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name
is JP the Kicker.
I used to move snowflakes.
You're listening to the boss of the big ball.
Then you can call me CEO of the ROC.
Giving you that grease.
Back at you live, JP the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express. Public service announcement. I fly it in a piece of paper, bear my name. Nobody better in the game. Got him back on the line with me, Troy West from TroyWins.com. Thank you so much, Troy, for spending your Saturday morning with me. You could be anywhere, but you chose to be here on the big board with JB, and I really do appreciate it. Again, college basketball is on deck. You can get over to our friends, FuboTV.com, Paramount Plus. We'll get you where you need to be. So we're coming into about the last 10 minutes of the show. Wanted to throw some games out there at you. Do you have any games that you wanted to maybe let fans know about that they can get off of your website? It may be college basketball, maybe some NBA. I know you've been streaking in both of those arenas as far as the sports betting goes. Go ahead.
Yeah, JB, one that I've got on my slate, I like the Oregon Ducks. They're starting to play better basketball. They took care of Washington at home just a couple nights ago. They've got Washington State at home tonight. It's a tough place to play. Washington State snuck by Oregon State last week. I like Oregon to get it done. I think they're -3.5. That's one of the games that I've got circled today. I'll give you another one. We've got a lot of cross action today, JB. We've got some conference play going out of conference. Kent State's getting 7.5 today at home against Troy. Troy's a good basketball team. Kent State's outstanding at home. Give me Kent State at home as an underdog, JB, and this could be a money line winner, +250, +300. Kent State at home is getting 7.5. I like Kent State a lot. And then one more, JB. Gonzaga headed into Kentucky today, JB. Gonzaga's been under the radar. They have not been good this year, but I like them getting 5.5, 6. Gonzaga goes into Kentucky and covers, and they might win that game outright as well.
Let's talk about it. Rotation number 7-11. This is your lucky day, Troy. The picks that you are bringing out, again, the +800 for Purdue to go all the way to the national championship and chip it up. And then you're talking about this game today. Again, rotation number 7-11, just pulling it up on my board here. Gonzaga on the road, +4.5. Road dog is barking here, +175. Kentucky at home, rotation number 7-1-2, -4.5, -210. Total is 169. So we'll finish up with this game here. When you go into it, you talked about Calipari not having the one and dones. Ranked number 17, Kentucky is on average a top five, at least a top 10 team, but they're still in the top 25. -4.5. They're only 7-7 at home against the spread. So I kind of see where you're going here with the Kentucky Wildcats. If you're talking about a team that's 500 at home, 16-6 overall, 11-3 at home straight up, though, and Gonzaga coming in at 3-2 on the road. Who are going to be some of the key players that you want to look at today if you're going to take those Gonzaga Bulldogs, which is the dog that you said is barking? It's going to be a cat fight. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's going to be a great fight. I mean, Mark Few gets this team up against the big game, right, JB? Gonzaga historically, and they've been battle-tested all year. They've played UConn. They've played St. Mary's. They've played Tennessee. They've played a really tough non-conference schedule. So I just think Gonzaga is capable of going in. Kentucky 16-6 this year. Like I said, not a lot of star power. Again, Gonzaga's been very inconsistent. This is a team that was preseason ranked top 10. They've had a lot of slip-ups throughout the course of the year. They're starting to play a little bit better basketball. They did just lose at home to St. Mary's by 2. If they would have gotten that win, I think they would have been back in the top 25. I expect Watson to have a big game tonight. Hickman, this is still a good Gonzaga team. That's why I think they're capable of going. They love the test like this. They love going on the road. They love the big game on the road. That's why I think Gonzaga can get the job done and win this one outright.
I like it, too. I like the rotation number 7-11. Take the Gonzaga Bulldogs on the road. Again, Troy West, thank you so much for coming by the big board this morning. That's it, man. College basketball Saturday is a wrap. Again, when you come back to Las Vegas next week, man, I'm going to be looking forward to going over to the book with you. Didn't touch too much on the ACC. We got another game here. I just wanted to throw this out here last couple of minutes. We got NC State, rotation number 715. The ACC has been in a down year in college basketball so far. We haven't seen that many teams filling out the top 25. Normally, it would be about half the conference, but we got a couple swimming in there. Carolina and Duke, I think, is still up locked in there. But NC State, rotation number 715, plus 8, plus 280. Total is 152. Going to Wake Forest, just a couple of miles down Tobacco Road. Rotation number 716, the Wake Forest Demon Deacons, minus 8, minus a 350 on this play. When you talk about a home guy, minus 350 at home in a college basketball, you got to be an alumni to take that bet. Go ahead, Troy.
Yeah, baby, I like NC State, another good road dog. I mean, this is cross-rival ACC basketball. That's just too many points. NC State still talented. This is the tournament team last year. Close ball game, but I'll take NC State getting that many points all day.
We like NC State as well. And again, looking at the top 25 here, I only see two teams out of the ACC. You got Duke and North Carolina. Come on, ACC. Pick it up. Put it back together. But again, Troy West from TroyWins.com. Thank you so much for stopping by. Any final shout-outs before we get out of here, man, and we get over to the betting book and get our day started? Go ahead.
Yeah, shout-out to you, JB. Best in the business. I appreciate you very much. Looking forward to being in Las Vegas next weekend with you. I'm going to wait to put in my Purdue bet, JB. I'm going to be with you when I put that baby in. That's good mojo for both of us. And all the viewers out there, be ready for this one. This ticket's going to blow you guys away next weekend.
We're going to put some cash in your pocket again. Troy West, you're going to be back tomorrow for my big game preview. You know, we would have liked it to be somewhere. But again, Troy West from TroyWins.com, he knows what time it is when you come out to Vegas. So again, Troy, we look forward to having you back tomorrow. And we'll say it together. Let's get the money.
Get the money, baby.
You're listening to the Boss of the Big Four. JP the Kicker. Vegas scoreboard express.
Giving you that green.